And a paramecium. See, it's like moving around. Hang on. I get. Yeah, tilt it to the side so the cover thing doesn't block it. Hang on. Oh, I can't really do it anyway. God, this fucking torch lights. I'm dying anyway. Can see it moving around. There's two of them. Single-celled organisms you can see without a microscope. Kind of like, hang on. If I stand it up, maybe? We had to focus it. Anyway. They stop moving. Shake it around a bit. Can't really see anymore. Maybe just run out of energy and oxygen. Because I've had this in this vial for quite a few hours already. This is sourced from the Perth Zoo. Like, I see something moving there. You can see it. Yeah. Yeah, it stopped moving. Yeah. I tried to place onto a slide. But I couldn't get any on it, unfortunately. It's actually quite hard to get them on the slide in the first place. All I've got here is just sand, unfortunately. I actually do have a few single cell organisms in there, but they're not paramecium. They're really, really, really tiny, and it's hard to tell what they are. My microscope's not good enough. The focal distance of the foldscope, that is this thing. The focal distance of the foldscope is actually shorter than the thickness of the cover slips I'm using, which is like insane. Makes the cover slip kind of useless, but I use the thick ones because it's easier to apply without crushing everything. You don't want to crush your sample, because then you don't have anything to look at, it just turns into goo.